Good evening, everybody. I'm going to give you some input about Theory U, which is a model that has been by the way, modeled by Otto Scharmer, which is who is a senior lecturer at the MIT Sloan Institute, MIT, in economics. So, starting this hackathon at home, to start this hackathon at home, it seemed important to me that we take a short review on what's going out there, because we have been submitted to very big constraints, and it's nice that we as a community start working together for a better world, but all this has to make sense, and I'm going to try to improve global awareness of what is happening to us and how we might get out of all this mess. Well, starting from I will start with a short presentation of what Otto Scharmer. I'm just selecting my screen so you are going to see my first slide. It's okay. You should now be seeing my first slide, in which is an extract from Otto Scharmer's book, From Ego to Ecosystems. From Ego Systems to Ecosystem. Otto Scharmer says, we are living now in an ecosystem world. And he describes it. As you can see it on this slide, with three divides, three disconnects, which are ecological, this is obvious for everyone. Social divide is also pretty obvious for mostly everyone. And the spiritual divide, which is maybe less obvious, but is the inner space in which we can have a meaningful life. So, I just had a message. Okay, so Catherine is telling me that everything is okay, so I'm going to go on. Underneath, you can see the bubbles. Our system, obsolete system, has been inflating, and which is laid upon some beliefs, which are only beliefs, sadly. The first one is the paradigm of the infinite growth. No comment. Our planet is not infinite, so there would be a lot to say about this. I'm going to go on. The income bubble is based on a belief that the income we get is the meaning of our life, and taking too much from the planet. And also violating human rights of some people in order to satisfy some others, and etc. We could go on over all these bubbles: financial bubble, technology bubble. Well, a belief that technology is going to solve everything. Technology is going to help us, but technology is going to be serving the main purpose and not taken like un objectif en français, like it's not the challenge is not only technology, right? The challenge is also about human things. The leadership bubble, but the way companies are led nowadays is also based on control, which paralyzes the agility of companies. Consumerism bubble, the belief here is GDP, which is what we earn, brings happiness. And we can see that it's not the truth. The governance bubble, which is mainly in a lot of countries. Thank you, Catherine. A goal or target is not a final goal. Huh? I said with the technology as itself, as it is not a goal. It's not a final goal. It's a means, and it has to be placed again at its position of being a goal. Governance. Well, democracies are failing, dictatures are rising, and so on. So we can see that mostly politicians are voiceless. The last one is the ownership bubble, and maybe the most revolutionary bubble described by Otto Scharner, which is we have to own our house, we have to own our car to be happy, we have to own a piece of the planet to be happy. And unfortunately, this is also a belief which slows down the transition towards a better world. So he describes here four levels of capitalism. The first capitalism level is a state-centric, which is based on hierarchy and control. I already talked about this. It's an awareness level which is ordinarily accepted by mostly everybody, and this capitalism 2.0 is the belief that a free market and competition is going to regulate the economy. And this is unfortunately based on egos, on I am going to make a better result than you, and if I can, I'm going to kill you, economically speaking. Our society has been more or less evolving towards capitalism 3.0 and trying to add some regulation to the market, bringing networks, negotiation, taking into account others' opinions, and so on. Stakeholder awareness, which is more or less, we are going to negotiate. But negotiation, most of the time, leads to the lowest result we could expect, sadly again. And Otto Scharner says we are now on the threshold of opening a new way of doing things, which is the co-creative economy, which implies acting from the whole, and which is the ecosystem awareness, which is a level of consciousness that makes us act from the ecosystem, taking into account all the aspects of the ecosystem. That's for me a nice way of analyzing what is happening lately, what has been happening lately, and will sadly again happen in underdeveloped countries in the following months with the pandemic. We don't know how terrible the effects are going to be. Well, I'm going to go forward with my presentation of theory U. And just something important is, why have we been doing so many mistakes? And one of the answers is that we are acting from our blind spot, which is we don't really know what is our intention when we act. And the future world is going to be nice if we make this movement towards inside us and ask the real questions. The real questions is with what is my intention? What am I going to do now, and why am I going to do that? And who am I is the main question. Who am I, and what's my position in life? Why have I been put into this life, and what to make it, what for? And the process is the second step, and the result, the what, is only the result of these two previous steps. So we are going now to examine how Otto Scharmer suggests we can get in touch with this inner space, which already holds the answers of, to our main questions. Here you can see why we call this model theory U. It's because you can see there U. And we are not going to comment in a detailed way all of this pattern. You are going to be able to read the book From Ego to Eco. It's easy to find on Amazon. If you find somebody else, another library, it's going to be better. So here we have the U process. It says if we don't want to reproduce the old mistakes, we have to find another way to do things. And we have to somehow abandon the downloading attitude, which consists in taking the same people, the same ideas, and start again, and start again, and start again, and get always the same results. In order to avoid these old patterns, Otto Scharmer suggests we start seeing with fresh eyes, open our mind, and then get inside ourselves and listen to the heart. Open also your heart and sense from the field, redirect your attention to what is really happening for other people. Open your empathy capacity, your capacity, your skills in understanding others, listening to others, taking time for others, and so on. And then you could say, well, I've opened my mind, I've opened my heart, but now I know what is to be done. And this would be a mistake also, because Otto Scharmer suggests that we take another movement, which is letting go, and let go is I know that we are having a big problem. I'm seeing with my eyes. I know that we are having a big problem, and I acknowledge it in my heart. But I don't have the answer. You know, here it's a time we are living now because we are all confined, which is the best opportunity we have to let go on our beliefs, on what we believe is true, and so on. And ask ourselves the right questions. Who is myself? What is my work? Who am I? And what am I expected to do in this life? This needs something which is very difficult because it's going to awake our fears, which is connecting the source, what Otto Chalmers calls presencing, which is presence and sensing, which is a moment which is not easy to live because we have no solution at this time. We just have questions. We just have problems. And the point here is letting come is wait a little bit more so that the right solution emerges. And don't try to make the solution yourself. Don't try to be the solution yourself. So, and then, fortunately, Otto Chalmers says, and I have lived this experience with teams and people many times, there is a way up on the right side of the U. This is a good news. And the good news is that whenever we go through all this path, we are going to see something crystallizing, a vision and an intention that we didn't perceive before. And this is a creative process, which means something new is emerging, and things are not going to be the same afterwards. And then another humility, very necessary in our world and in this process, is don't think that now that you have got the big idea, you are going to make a deployment at a world scale. And stay humble, prototype, remain centered on yourself, remain centered or concentrated on your intent and so on, and work with the humility of saying, maybe I'm not going to have the solution yet. Maybe I can still make mistakes. And which preserves in ourselves a way of performing which is different, which is which is operating from the whole, is operating and from the position of being part of the system. Oh, maybe you are going to tell me what has this to do with the hackathon at home, because we are going to develop technological solutions, etc., etc. Why is this important? Because I think a good project starts by asking the right questions. And this process is like a milestone and an opportunity to ask to pause regularly, periodically, and say, are we still seeing with fresh eyes what we are doing? Are we still sensing? Are we still listening to each other? Are we still taking enough time to let go, enough time to ask ourselves the right questions, and so on and so on. Are we really prototyping with our future customers, or are we imagining the perfect solution without testing it? So this is really like a series of milestones in your pathway for these four weeks. And I really believe that you can be more effective if you pause from time to time and say, okay, let's take the new process and see how it's going. Is it going to help us now? Because maybe we are losing the sight to in our intent, our intention, our basic idea, and how we want it to really help people. This is the first good reason you may find for using CRAU in helping you in building your project. There is another one. And this is the bad news. I'm going to go back to awful things. And show you what is going to happen if you don't do it. Because we have, in reality, we don't have real choice. You will find here in this illustration, this figure, the same EU process I commented just before. And this is, Otto Scharmer says, this is the space for social emergence to create economies of creation. But you can see above the inverted U. And what is going to happen if we don't enter in this social emergence and economy of creation, we are going to carry on with economies of destruction and social pathology. If we don't go to open our minds, open our hearts, open our will, we are very likely to go here stuck with our own truth, to remain stuck inside my little ego that wants every time more, and stuck in one self and one will, and never change my mind. Here, we have a real good description of what is happening in many countries, but I particularly like to take Donald Trump's example, because you see here first, if you get blind, you don't open your mind, you are going to deny the truth. And if you deny the truth and stay here and stay blocked in this denial, you are going to entrench, which is you are going to desensitize yourself from your emotions. You are going to cut yourself from emotions and enter in a desensing process and become emotionless towards people who suffer, people who are in difficulties, and there are many people nowadays in hospitals. But if you distance yourself because you deny the truth, the number of people who die, etc., you are going to disconnect yourself from the reality. And this is going to lead you to absencing. Which is you are going to get stuck in your process, and the more you get further in this process of social pathology, the more you are going to be a prisoner of the process, and you are going to be obliged to manipulate others, because you need allies, you need friends, you need people who want to, and you need to manipulate others. In order to that they help you eluding the truth, which is lying, by the way. And then afterwards, all this leads to abortion, disembodying, and destruction. And that's it. So nowadays, our economies of destruction have showed their limits, the limits of the planet, the limits of destruction of nature, of animals, and so on. And we have to get out of this social pathology to enter in social emergence, economies of creation, and make a clear choice between these two spaces. I'm being quite negative, maybe, when I say that, but I think we have to open our minds, open our heart, and open our will very fast, because otherwise we are going to be in big trouble. I have finished my presentation for today. I will be very happy to work with a project group in the next weeks. And I hope everybody takes some time to listen to the presentation. I'm sorry for my English, but I have been doing better as the time goes on. So I think I should be able to help you even in English. Bye-bye, everybody, and I'm impatient to connect with my team. I would like to thank the organizer of Hackathon at Home, and happy to be with you. So have a nice evening, and see you next time. Bye-bye.